So you know how I like the Black Crowes, right?
I know you were big on them.
Yeah, no, I just love their sound. I love Chris Robinson's voice. I love the way the band plays, and just their overall sound is just great.
Very cool and just very retro.
Yeah.
Even the clothes they wear, you know, they're just.
But you've never been a huge fan, from what I remember.
No, there's certain aspects that I'm not huge on, but I know that the Robinson brothers are good musicians, good down-home boys, you know.
Well, Rich Robinson, the guitarist of the Black Crowes, started a new band called the Magpie Salute. They started in 2016, and he actually brought a couple of Black Crowes members with him for this new band. So YouTube's...
YouTube, yeah.
Yeah, YouTube's magical algorithm suggested this to me. So I had to listen to this one song called Omission. And I think it's a really cool song. I dig their sound again. It's reminiscent of the Black Crowes, of course, but very different because it doesn't sound like Chris Robinson vocally.
You know, what was omitted?
Chris Robinson.
maybe that was it.
Maybe. Right. I don't know.
Cool.
But anyway, we're going to have a listen to Omission by the Magpie Salute right after this. Okay. So the Magpie Salute playing Omission. Here we go.
Do it.
Taking our two
So I thought that was very reminiscent of the Black Crowes.
Yeah, it definitely had the tint, that tinge to it.
What did you think? Did you like it? Is it?
What I'm smelling already is an agree to disagree situation.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
I was trying to think as I'm watching it, it's got that groove to it. There's no question. And there, you know, there's a part of them are trying to be retro, but that's like, it felt like Black Crowes, if they were still playing today, what they would sound like.
Mm-hmm.
So that's in part to what you're saying,
which to me is a great thing.
I liked it, a couple of songs where they kind of were really retro, but I guess it takes me back that I just like classics better than that current flavor. So I don't know why. I just, for that song, I was trying to think of some great things to say to make a good show, good for the show. I got nothing out of that.
Well, you're an idiot.
I just don't like it. I hope it's over soon.
Really?
Yeah. That's way through. Crazy. I'm sorry. I wanted to like it. I swear to God. God be with me.
Well, you know, not everyone is.
I really wanted to like it.
I get it. But I'm just surprised because I thought you liked rock and roll.
It's the beauty of being that whole thing. It's totally, you know, at the end of the day, it's totally subjective. That's the biggest word we can say about this whole thing.
Yeah.
So you know what I figured, you know, what's really good for it is pure honesty. It's just.
Oh, of course. Yeah. You didn't like it. You know, I don't like all the ones you suggest either. So there.
Well, look, when you get older, it's not about it sucked. It didn't suck.
No.
It just wasn't for me. And that's cool. Honesty.
Well, and that's pretty much how it's always been between us when it comes to the Black Crowes, because you were never a big fan, and you've always been like meh on everything. You acknowledge, they're good musicians, but meh. And I'm just the other way. I hear them and I have to turn them up. I love their sound, and they just
but
get
there's
so
different variations of why you like music, and part of it is influenced by. Either when you heard it was a bad time, that whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, you know, part of it, I think, is for some reason you heard something that just you didn't like then, mm-hmm. and it just rubbed you for some reason. And so if you're being purely honest, it's going to be really what you felt. And I was just like, God, I wish I liked this. That's my whole feeling. Yeah.
Well, you know, the funny thing is when I saw this in my feed, I had to listen to it, and I added it to my list of songs we should react to. And it wasn't until this very morning that I found out that it was an offshoot of the Black Crowes, because I actually just thought, oh, here's a cool new band. We should react to this. I really like their sound. And then I find out, oh, they actually are, you know, three members of the Black Crowes. So no wonder I like it. So it just shows that, I just dig that sound. And when I heard this, I was like, ooh, yeah, this is cool. I like this.
Look, I matured, and I'm the first to say that whether I like it or not, and that again is the difference, is when I hear the name Black Crowes, I just think, hey, it's cool. We're cool guys playing rock.
You would skip it
but
if
that's
it came
because
out.
It just doesn't do it for me. Then I go, you know, whatever phase I was, though, that it was out. I think it really influences it. It is when it came out, where were we in our lives? And I was definitely not listening to that. I was just listening to the guitar
player. I only really started listening to the Black Crowes much more recently than like in college, in the 90s. There was the one Black Crowes song that came out that I just loved. And I think we even played it in our band. What is it? Pretty Little Thing. Let Me Light Your Candle.
You were like super
hard to handle. Oh my God.
You learned that right away and you were singing it all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And but that's pretty much where my Black Crowes ended back then, until, you know, fast forward into the early 2000s. And then that's when I started listening to more of their stuff, and just, you know, kind of fell in love with that sound. So when these guys, when Magpie Salute, you know, when I started hearing them, I was just like, you know, this is great. It's a, like you said, it's a continuation of the Black Crowes. It's what they would sound like now if they were still playing. And, and to me, that's a great thing.
Hey, it's just, you know, it's the same thing then. I don't know how many years it's been, what year that was, but it's the same feeling for me. Back then, I was just like, respect his taste. Mm-hmm. It just didn't fly for me.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I didn't notice it was cool music. It was guitar-based music.
Right.
And it hit, and God bless him for it, you know? So, yeah. I mean, no, that's my stance. And, you know, there's nothing, when I look back again, it's not a negative term. I'm not looking at Marilyn Manson or some.
No, it's exactly how I feel about Journey, for example, one of your favorite bands. I skip them every time. I respect them. I think they're great musicians. I just don't like their music. I'm just not a fan.
Listen, like I try to force myself watching shit for you. I watched yesterday. I'm going, oh, Supertramp. I want to fucking do that. And I'm watching when he's not gonna, that I'm just searching for a Supertramp song. That's because it was just Dreamer. And, but yeah. I really respect them. They're Supertramp. It was great. It's all positive, but
this is exactly where personal taste comes into play, because it has all the elements. It just, for some reason, is put together in a way that doesn't excite you. And it's exactly the same with like Journey for me. They have all the elements of what makes a great rock band. It's just not my thing. So, hey.
Well, and things changed when we got to this point in our lives and careers, that it's a matter of like, look, guitar rock is alive. That's good enough right now at this point. Really?
Yeah.
So very good on them that they're playing and having a good time and playing guitar, and it's rock music and it's grooving. Yeah. And I wish I liked it more, in parentheses. That's all. You know.
All right. Well, this is one of those rare occasions, I think, where we're pretty, you know, diametrically opposed in opinion, but cool, you know?
Yeah. That's why really comments on this type of thing is not going to be argumentative in any way. It's just like, hey, I like this.
Exactly.
Like it,
yeah.
You know, but just share if you do like it. If you don't like it, share that.
Yeah. Are you team Ed or team Doug?
Yeah. But it's not a matter of that, because I respect it for sure.
No, I know.
It's really just, if somebody really loves it, just, show your passion.
Awesome. Well, that was the Magpie Salute. I will definitely be listening to more of them.
And you know what? Because of those same YouTube algorithms, it's important that you hit like, please, and subscribe to the channel, and definitely hit the bell. That's telling YouTube, hey, you want to see us in the suggestions. You can see when we come out with new stuff.
Yes. Very important.
So fight the algorithms. Fight the power.
All right. Until next time, rock and roll.
Salute.